Vince only got three matches, and that's cool because we only got three matches, and this was a tag team matchup, and this is the way we start this tag team matchup on main event. We got a tag team action kind of match going on here. That's what we got going on here. Welcome to main event, ladies and gentlemen. That's the way I started. I'm Rookie. You guys should know this if you're on my channel. That's right, my channel, which is still going through it. How the fuck am I producing all these episodes? Why am I doing it? Why? Because I have nothing else to do, and this is my baby. But welcome, and this is the Usos, one of the WWE's hottest tag teams at the moment. And it's just a shame that they are not the number one contender for world tag team titles. They are actually in competition with the Brotherhood. The Authority have not named the number one contender yet for Cesaro and Tyson Kidd's tag team championships. But hopefully we get to see this in the coming time, and hopefully we see the Usos drop the beat. And we see the Usos become the one contenders. But hey, there's a new tag team on the scene, and their names are Chris Jericho and The Miz. Two people I thought did not like each other. But hey, they'll team up. Jimmy Uso honoring his Samoan heritage with his traditional face paint. You know, Cole, I don't think it's coincidence that Uso's career really seemed to take off after they started wearing the face paint. Go Usos. And here we go. Here comes the former tag team champion, Chris Jericho, baby. Yeah, baby. Chris Jericho was here on main event last week in the Battle Royal where he was eliminated and lost. And I thought it was going to be saved with Jericho from freaking Authority, but it did not turn out to be that way. Today was Kofi Kingston from the Authority. This is the first time we'll see The Miz and Jericho team up. Jeremiz. Let's call the scene that. Jeremiz. I don't know how these two are going to work together, you know. I don't know if Jericho could stand The Miz. I don't know if Chris Jericho could put up with him. Chris Jericho, a fan favorite, and Zack Ryder not here tonight. Zack Ryder said he's in NXT. He's going to go to NXT. He's going to train there. He's going to get better at NXT. Then when he's ready to come up and do it, he's going to come up to the WWE, win the Intercontinental title, win the US title, whichever one comes up, and then he'll take the WWE and World Championship. So, Zack Ryder will be a world champion by WWE 2K16, according to him. So, we'll see what happens. But as we see Chris Jericho in his light bright jacket, he's got it going on. Break down the walls, Jericho. What you want? All right, guys, let's see what goes on right here. Here comes the most must-see WWE superstar who thought he was going to be going for the US title, and yet he still might be going for it. This United States Championship picture has not been shown yet, but according to the Authority, the Big Show might be added to it. Just because of the match that he had with Ryback, we didn't see it. It was pretty cool for the short match it was. It was pretty good, pretty impactful, and it was a pretty big matchup right there. But he might get one. The Miz looks like he might get another chance to do a championship. I don't know. I don't know yet. I don't know what's going on here. We might get the Ryback versus The Miz. As the Mike The Miz slapping people on. But maybe he'll have double duties at Payback if him and Jericho show that they can beat the WWE Titans tag team. Maybe they might get a number one contendership match and a match for that big time title. The Miz has cool hair in these little things, but we'll see what happens. Ta-da. So we're gonna let this match play along. Start the match. Welcome, as it will be Jericho against the Usos. Here we go. And King, you can feel the excitement in the air. Something memorable will happen here tonight. We're starting off strong, Michael, and things are just gonna keep getting better. He's in big trouble. You see that goal? Talk about getting your spine adjusted. Jeez. Jey Uso's plan has got him on a roll here tonight. One of the reasons Chris Jericho is so difficult to defeat is his mix of offensive maneuvers. Jericho's blended wrestling styles from everywhere he's been, so he can hit you with enziguris, power bombs, and a variety of high flying moves. Oh, and we can't forget about his lion salt. Reversal there.
kick. Well, that's devastating. Watch out here.
Okay. Don't let it get to your head, because if it gets to your head, I don't know if I can ever tell you that you're cool again, because then I feel like hey, you'll never be able to tell you.
Sometimes I don't like complimenting Chris Jericho, because we've certainly had our differences in the past. But you're right, Cole. His opponents get hit with everything and the kitchen sink. Just watch Jericho's knee lift. Ooh, that did it.
Go and get rehired just so your Snapchat can start getting all Lex entertainment and all that. That's all you guys need. It's bad.
He saw that one coming.
No.
Man. Hey, Jimmy Uso finding a path of destruction currently. No, not again.
I hope not.
Oh, man, you want to talk offense? Jimmy Uso's bringing the thunder of Samoa with him into battle. Super kicks, dives out onto the floor. A full Nelson bomb.
You're probably wondering, Rookie, where the fuck were you for the last 2 minutes? I was sending Snapchats, I'm sorry. I have a Snapchat, guys. You all want to follow me? It's Juan Likes Pizza 3. Like the number 3. If you guys want to follow me on Snapchat, you want to talk to me, I'm always available to talk. But as we see, is the Miz and Jericho working together against the Usos. This is a good pairing. I didn't think it'd be happening here. Look at these two using tag team maneuvers. Chris Jericho might just be a tag team specialist going on into now, into his career part right here. The tag team specialist, Chris Jericho. What else has he not been the best in the world? Now he will be the best in the world if having one of the best in the world tag teams in the world. And here comes a shot to the back. And the Usos need to step it up right here. But again, this is what the Usos do. The Usos just let the other team think. We're going to win. We're going to do our thing. Nope. But tonight they're facing a former world champion and a former WWE champion and a former WWE champion in The Miz. So they're facing a team that have done pretty well successfully in the realm of singles competition. And there's a super kick right there. There's only one thing left to do. Come on, man, you gotta go for that pin. The pinfall. One. Super kick did not work. But can he go for one more thing? And that's that Samoan splash, baby. That Uso splash. Yeah, ooh, that splash that makes people go, oh damn. So the Usos right here are gonna make a tag team right here. This could be the move right here they need. Look at the Usos dropping him down. They got it. Splash Mountain, baby. That's it. Jericho's done. Get the pin. Oh, the Miz comes in. And the save right there. That makes the Miz do a good. That's a good tag team partner right there. Saving your ass when you need that help. And the Usos know that, hey, okay. They're not going to stop. This is going to be a tag team that does not want to lose tonight. So we're going to have to be on top. A high elbow jump right there. He knows it's going to hurt more if you're doing it from high up. Another super kick. The Usos going for the pin. One. Oh, come on. DDT. Jericho. Oh, God. Caught into the Samoan splat and Samoan drop. I wonder if a Mexican did it. Would it be called the Mexican drop? I don't think it would be. And here we go. Chris Jericho now has an Uso in the corner. And Jericho, what is Jericho doing? What the hell? Oh, watch this. The Ayatollah of Rock and Roller dropping you outside of the Ringatollah. Did that not run? The Miz now working on Uso number 2 out there. And he's coming after him. And look at this. Isn't cool, man. You can't.
And it looks like we could be heading back into
the Miz
ring.
Is back. Miz throws him back in the ring. Chris Jericho in full control. Jericho dragging him by the arms. Looking right in front of his tag team partner. He's like, I got you. Look at this. Kicks to the face. What you gonna do about it, huh? And you ain't gonna do shit. And Chris Jericho definitely making sure that he's not gonna do anything. As the Miz is telling him, I need to tag in, man. Tag me in. This is the only time. The Miz wants to come in here. But Jericho's not making the tag. But maybe now Jericho's thinking, now, okay, I see the Miz. I see him wanting to get in my ring. But no, the Usos are like, you're weak, Jericho. Look at this roll up pin right here. Trying to get the win like that. That would have been a nice way to win it. Really quick, really easy. But the Miz is still good then. The Miz is still up, and he's still going to be able to protect his tag team partner for now. Unless the Usos are able to get this together. And the tag right here. Here we go. The Usos looking good. Look at the splash again. Another Splash Mountain. Splash Mountain. Number two. Pinfall. The Miz is back in the ring. One. And I save yet again. These saves are saving his life, man. It's not cool at all. And there's the Integuri. I'm just kidding. I don't even know if it's Integuri. I don't think it is. Is it? You think it is. I think it is. And now Jericho's like, I got to tag in the Miz, don't I? And here comes the Miz. The most must-see WWE superstar coming in to take on the Usos. What can he do? The Hollywood A-lister. Today has been a movie you wish you could be in. And the Miz now in full control. Neckbreaker by the Miz. The former WWE champion, the former United States champion, the former tag team champion, the former Intercontinental champion. The former everything is still doing his thing here. The former cast member of the real world. Just got a shock of the real world right there by the Uso. There's a high knee right there into the face of the Miz. The Miz needs to be that guy that nobody seems to care or stop. A shot to the gut right there. The Usos need to get. Oh no. Look at the Miz. Look at the Miz. Who said the Miz can't do anything? He just kicked him down. And the Miz is like, come on. I'm ready to put you out of your misery here. And he goes for it. Oh, look at that face bust. Ooh, there's only one thing left, Miz, and that's the Skull Crushing finale. Pinfall. One. Two. Oh, not even a two count. Miz, you got to get the Skull Crushing finale. You're going to want to win this one. That's simple as that. But look at the Usos. They're not going to stop. Super. Oh, I thought he was going for a super kick. No, he's going for a kick. Oh, there it is. A super kick. The Usos got something beautiful. Pinfall. One. Two. Three. Oh, I thought that was a three count. No, it was not a three count. Almost a three count in my imagination. And the Miz now has the counter here. And the Miz has him over there in front of his bro. And the Miz says, like, here we go. Clothesline. I'm going to get him out of here. The Miz with a nice, impressive clothesline. The Miz now. The one thing you got to do, Miz, set him up. Set him up. Here it is. Skull crushing finale time. He wants to hit him with it. He wants to end this one. Where's Jericho to stop him? There's a skull crushing finale. The Miz has got it. Pinfall. One. Ah, oh, and there's a save right there. What a way to kick off Man and Moon tag team action. Just when you think one of them is going to get it, the other one makes a save. That's tag team action. And the Miz is like, I got this. I need the face. That knee could have definitely given him a concussion. And here goes the Miz looking for a pinfall, looking for the win. Oh, look at Jericho. Jericho playing it smart. Oh, but that's a kick out right there. That right. Jericho was playing it smart. Jericho with the smart tag team maneuver. And they're going out there. Look at Jericho. He's working on him. And now the Suso bro needs to get himself all by himself and do what he's going to do here, because this could be beautiful. Jay. Is this a superplex? Superplex on the Miz. Superplex. 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 Pinfall. This could be it. One. Two. Oh, kick out by the Miz. Jericho couldn't come in running, though. That's the bad thing right there. The Miz in trouble. Because the Usos looking like they're about to get into Splash Mountain mode. There's only one thing to do. Give him a shot there. Yeah, come on. A high elbow. Oh, come on, man. That's a debilitating move right there. As the crowd right now just looking and waiting to see what happens in this tag team matchup. A good way to start off main event. These guys going all out for it. They know what it means. They know that the tag team gold are on the line. Well, a chance to face off for tag team gold is on the line. In this business, that's all that matters. Those championships, man. Not the sluts, not the money. The tag team titles. And there's the five. Oh, here we go. The Usos looking to end this one. They want to put this one up bed. Look at that super high Samoan drop. Pinfall. The Miz could be out. Jericho trying to come in here. He's not going to make it. Because that's tag team wrestling right there. Watching his back. The Usos watching each other's back. And that's why they are one of the hottest tag teams in the WWE. The Miz and Jericho lose to the Usos. Shows you the chemistry you need to have as a tag team. You just can't put anyone together. You need to have chemistry before you can start winning. And look at this right here. Bam! The Usos definitely did exactly what they had to do to win this one. Super kick right there on Jericho. Jericho went down, man. Jericho was not looking like Jericho. Jericho has not looked like Jericho in a while. He threw him right there. Samoan drop right there. And look, here it comes, the tag team. Look at this. He sees it right there. Jericho coming in and says, I got him. We got this. The Usos with another win. Main event in the Usos, man. Looking good. These are like, we deserve a tag team championship match. Come on. Give us those tag team titles. That's what we deserve. Doesn't matter who's in our way. We get it. We deserve it. Let's get on to the next match. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, Tamina Snuka asked for this matchup against Cameron here tonight. And Cameron was like, girl, you want a match with me? You want me to show you off again? Okay. Especially after what Tamina said. Tamina said last week was just a fluke. Last week she didn't realize all the pressure that was on her got on her. And she said that following this past Monday Night Raw where she picked up the win for her team, she felt right. She felt like it's time for her to actually get a rematch. It's time for her to show Cameron that, hey, last week was a fluke, and you're not going to beat me. I'm going to beat you tonight. So Cameron Knight was like, girl, please, I'm going to beat you. And it's going to show why I deserve a chance for the Women's Championship. And then we're going to see you. Bye-bye. And Cameron will be facing Tamina Snuka here tonight in one-on-one action with Natalya on the outside. Natalya, the number one contender for the Divas Championship. She's the number one contender for the Divas Championship because she is using her rematch clause that she had as a champion. And that's what Payback is going to be, a rematch kind of night. Except for John Cena's WWE Championship, but hey, that's a different story. Here comes Tamina Snuka. Tamina Snuka getting a lot of match time. She's been on this is four of the five episodes. Will the comeback begin tonight? Tamina Snuka's got Natty right behind her. Tamina Snuka, like I've been saying, I've been trying to push her to you guys. I've been trying to push for her, but she doesn't seem that she's able to get the win, but she got it on Monday. Now, will she continue this momentum, or was it just a fluke that she won on Monday for her team? I don't know, but I can tell you the authority, Stephanie McMahon, is going to be watching this as she's the head of the Divas division. Pretty sure she's going to be watching this matchup real close, and she's going to be like, I need somebody to win. And Tamina's like, I'm in this ring, bitch. I'm about to kick someone's head off. Tamina. Alright, here we go. Tamina versus Cameron on main events. See who wins this one. I got my money on Tamina, but Tamina, I can see it going anyway. Here we go. Both Divas doing a lockup here. Cameron's got the lockup right here. Cameron takes down Tamina right here. Now Cameron's like, I got the headlock on this chick. I'm going to choke her life out. But look at this. Tamina's like, hell to the no, ma'am. I'm gonna choke you out. You want to fight? Let's go right here. Takes her down right here. Tamina's got herself a piece of camera. Natty's looking at this saying, come on. These ladies are doing a little grapple wrestle. I did not expect this at all from these ladies right here. But they're doing this thing right here. They're trying to fight each other. And Tamina's getting choked out right there by the thighs of Cameron. And here we go. Cameron, though. Imagine if she gets a match at Battleground against Nikki Bella for the Women's Championship. And there's a big time splash right there. Natty's like, come on, Tamina. You got to get some going. And a big high knee right there. Cameron looking good right here. Tamina Snuka, you kind of look kind of not sharp. Not good right now. But here we go. This is what I'm talking about. She's going to do things like this that help her win the match like this. Come on. Come on. You can do this. This ain't nothing but a chicken wing. The feet are flying. Let the feet fly. Come on. Show me how your feet fly. And that's a missed drop kick if I've ever seen it. Bachomania, here we come. And Tamina Snuka gets an elbow to the face. And there comes kicks by Cameron. Cameron with a shot to the back. Someone tell Tamina Snuka she needs to wake up right now because she's in deep shit. Yes, that's how you do it. You gotta keep doing things like this. Both of you will not win this matchup, and there's another kick right there. Oh, come on.
Well, that was some reversal by Tamina. And that's a
Tamina Snuka definitely trying to take it right now to Cameron. And Cameron, she's been saying she's one of the most dominant divas. Now she's going to get her chance at a women's championship if she can win this. This is technically a number one contendership match in my mind. To see who will face Nikki Bella at Battleground for that women's championship. Or even before, or even sometime. Who knows what that title is going to be on the line next time. The Authority might not even want to ever defend that championship. And here's a takedown right there by Tamina Snuka. Tamina Snuka is like, yeah, see, I don't have to do that. Like, I can just take you down right there. I got an expertise of it. I can do super kicks. I can do everything I need to do. Look at Tamina Snuka, electric chair right here. That could be it right there. That could be enough to knock down Cameron. Oh, but Tamina's like, no, I don't think so. I think I need to do a little bit more. I think I need to kick her ass a little bit more. And there's a neck breaker right there by Tamina Snuka. Tamina Snuka looking real good right now. And this is what I told you about Tamina. She needs to get this momentum like this. She needs to look good. She needs to get it all together. And she's finally doing that thing right here. But Cameron out. Back in control. Now Tamina's like, yeah, you fucked up by not doing that. And look at Cameron. Cameron with a nice little counter right there. And Cameron trying to get back into this. But Tamina's like, yeah, this isn't going to happen. I'm going to wrench. I'm going to just attack your arm. Tell the referee, hold on. I can make her cry if I need to.
She's hooked.
Natty been on the side of Tamina Snuka. Even though Tamina once turned on Natty, Tamina said her sorry to Natty, and Natty was like, hey, I accept a lot. And Cameron is done, ladies and gentlemen. Cameron is girl bye. Tamina beats her yet again. She beats her opponents in an active anticlimactic way. But she beats her opponents, and at the end of the day, that is all that matters. Tamina Snuka looking good. She is possibly the future number one contender for that women's championship. Tamina Snuka, Nikki Bella. It could be our future of the women's championship match right there.
Here is your winner, Tamina Snuka. What an incredible match. That one could have gone either way. Nobody has anything to be ashamed of in this one.
Natty and Tamina celebrating this win. Like, this is good. This is what we need to take down the Bellas. This is it. We're the divas that are going to take him down. And Tamina smiling. Tamina happy to be the woman that's about to face off. Possibly with Nikki Bella. Not yet. I have no word on it. Main event. Guess what? Our main event's up next. Bad news, Barrett. Future number one contender for the world championship about to take on a past number one contender for the world championship and now number one contender for the intercontinental championship, Rob Van Dam. Bad news, Barrett. B&B versus RVD. Why not? Hey, one of a kind. Hey, one of a kind.
Many people call Rob Van Dam the whole damn show, and to be honest, they might not be too far off. That's because RVD can excite a crowd like no other, and that's a fact.
Now, Rob Van Dam needs to step it up tonight, man. Yes, I know. He does step it up every night, but you're facing the guy who's probably one of the most talented guys on the SmackDown roster. And Bad News Barrett. Bad News Barrett on a roll. Bad News Barrett can stop anyone that gets in his way. Bad News Barrett pretty much giving the show main event now for his ground to show how good he is. But RVD does not want to become one of those highlight reel kind of guys that's going to be put on the Titantron. No, he needs to show up tonight and he needs to give us him. He needs to kick some ass. Barrett will kick ass. RVD, show us why you're the number one contender for the championship. Show us why at Battleground you're going to give Randy Orton a fight for his life. And we'll see what happens here. As RVD is telling him, get your ass in here. I'm ready, suddenly. Let's go. Makes you believe I'm one of a kind. One of a kind. And now we are going to hit the button for the main event of main event. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you guys for watching this show. Thank you for leaving a like. Hopefully you do. Thank you for leaving a view. Thank you for leaving a comment. If you don't, then that's not cool, man. But thank you. And I have some deck chrome. Because I'm afraid I've got some bad news. It's the way this match starts right here.
I'll tell you this much, Michael. He can't wait to put a hurting on his opponent here.
RVD with the counter right here. We go around Van Dam right behind him. Grappling. He's gonna, trying to figure something out. Look at Van Dam taking him down. Van Dam's got a headlock on him right here. And this is the way you start off a matchup like this. You start off slow. And now here we go. Attacking. And look at Barrett. Now he has him up there.
Rob Van Dam, File King. RVD has his own unique official weightlifting move called appropriately enough the Van Dam lift. That has a nice ring to it. I hope Rob holds the world record.
Oh. All right, what's going on here?
Look at the ring.
Cesaro. What's Cesaro doing here?
What?
What the fuck?
You gotta be kidding me.
Oh, come on, Robin. You can't take advantage of this. Cesaro just took down Bad News Barrett.
What have we just seen?
The fuck?
I can't believe this. Everybody in this arena is in shock. This match is still going on, but it's gotta be academic here.
What the hell is that about? I don't know what that was about. Can my crack staff in the back figure that out? I just really want to know what the hell was that about.
Rob does own the world record for the Van Dam lift, though, but I think it's probably because he's the only person who's ever attempted it. It's an almost impossible maneuver. You have to perform a full split between two pitches while lifting a dumbbell. I'll leave that one to RVD.
You know, I'm just trying. Look at Rob Van Dam going really hard into that turnbuckle. Bad News Barrett, though, seems like that didn't really faze him at all because he's still on top and he's still kicking ass right now. The question is, though, why did Cesaro come out and attack Barrett and not Van Dam? I don't know. You know, Cesaro part of the authority. Barrett's not part of the authority. Neither is Rob Van Dam. Here's a kick out right here. Maybe, possibly, no. There's a kick out right there. That's what I was trying to fight against. Rob Van Dam and Wade Barrett Bad News Barrett going at it. I'm still calling him Wade Barrett. Why not? And here we go. Bad News Barrett knocks down Rob Van Dam. So that's my crack staff journalist going in the back. Anybody find out why Cesaro did what he did? No? Not yet? Okay. Well, it's okay, monkeys. It's cool. Barrett on top of Rob Van Dam delivering punches right here. These two are just showing off to show, hey, this is their movement in place of the at SmackDown. The SmackDown rank is pretty much double A. Oh, never mind. Just a regular spine buster into a pinfall. Not able to beat Rob Van Dam. Rob Van Dam able to get the rope breaks on that one. And here we go. Just trying to punch him in the back. And Rob Van Dam's like, what the fuck, man? Van Dam in deep shit. There's a big time suplex right there. That's how you do things like that. That's how you win matches. And look at Barrett trying to get Barrett can't get up as well because he got well assaulted by Cesaro. And Barrett's like, come on, man. And Barrett trying to go for a big hit. And now look at Van Dam with the kicks to the bottom. Van Dam just pulling the rug under Barrett right there. And Van Dam needs to wait a second. Look at Van Dam's athletic ability. Able to just to jump over you like this. Wait a second. Shh. Rolling Thunder. Rolling Thunder by Rob Van Dam. This could be the end for Barrett. 1, 2, 3. Barrett's done to a Rolling Thunder. Wow. Remember, he was attacked by Cesaro. So that could be a big effective reason why he couldn't kick out of that. Bad News Barrett went down. And RVD's like, fuck it, I'll take the match. Well, you got it. Oh, my monkeys have something, apparently. Cesaro says, this is for Rob Van Dam. And that the authority wanted to show that they show no favoritism in their match of Randy Orton against Rob Van Dam at Battleground. And Triple H says, you know, he knows that him and Van Dam have had personal histories in the backstage. This was just a way of him showing him there's no more problems. You and I, we can be on the same page. And I'm going to bring Cesaro out so you can win this matchup. Rob Van Dam wins. I don't know how he'll like that news, but What I do know is, Cesaro, I'm afraid I've got some bad news for you. The Swiss Superman and Bad News Bear might be in a collision course next week here on Main Event. I don't know. I don't make the show. But thank you guys for watching Main Event.